Welcome, everyone, and good afternoon. Our plan A was to be seated outside in the sunshine, but we did have plan B, fortunately, and so things are kind of turned around. But I hope you're comfortable and at least you're dry. Thank you. My name is Steve Zachard. I'm the City Fire Marshal and Public Information Officer for the St. Paul Fire Department. Fire Chief Tim Butler regrets that he couldn't be here today. He was requested to participate in the National Fallen Firefighter Memorial Service this weekend out in Emmitsburg, Maryland, the site of the country's National Fire Academy. He was asked to be an escort for the family of a firefighter who lost his life in the line of duty. In his place, Assistant Fire Chief Matt Simpson will be speaking to you on behalf of the Chief and the Fire Department. I'll be your MC. It's good to see you all here today. I'd like to especially recognize some honored guests, Mayor Chris Coleman, Council Member Chris Tolbert. We also have Carl Hinkle, who is Vice President of Tariff Construction, who built this, and James O'Shea is one of the architects that designed this addition. We're here for two reasons today. Oh, also want to also recognize the crew members of Engine and Medic 19, Ladder 10, which was relocated here in Parks, right where you're sitting, and all the men and women of all the brave men and women of the St. Paul Fire Department that are here today. We're here for two reasons. First is to recognize the beginning of National Fire Prevention Week. Secondly, to celebrate the expansion and the renovation, the midlife renovation of this 50-year-old fire station, Station 19, and how by doing this, we can better serve the community of Highland Park and the city of St. Paul. National Fire Prevention Week, first proclaimed by Calvin Coolidge back in 1825, is commemorated each year on the week of October 8th, the date of the Great Chicago Fire, when more than 250 people were killed and more than 17,000 buildings were destroyed in that two-day fire. A largely unknown coincidence is that on that very same day, October 8th, 1871, 1,152 people were killed in another massive fire in a place called Peshtigo, Wisconsin, up north in Wisconsin. It was, and still is, the most devastating fire in American history, except for the World Trade Center on 9/11. This year's fire prevention theme we're here to celebrate is Every Second Counts, Plan Two Ways Out. With the modern furnishings that we have in our home, made of synthetic materials or what I call solid gasoline, you've really only got 2 to 3 minutes to get out of your house when it's on fire before it flashes over. And flashover is when everything in the room ignites all at once, and nobody can survive a flashover. Firefighters themselves, with all their protective gear, just have seconds to get out when a room flashes over. So you have to be out of that room, out of that house in 2 or 3 minutes. So have a plan, seconds count, and practice that plan. Now, this is not the first Station 19 for the City of St. Paul Fire Department. Actually, this is the third one. The very first Station 19 was built way back in 1883, even before my time, at 745 Conway in the Dayton's Bluff neighborhood. And it was the home of then of Ladder 4 and Chemical 2. Engine 19 was first established here back in 1890, when Engine 19 was given birth, was born. The second Station 19 was built in 1930, and it's still standing today. It's by the Highland Park Water Tower. You might have seen it, you might recognize it. And it's owned now by the St. Paul Regional Water Services. We have t-shirts available for sale, commemorative t-shirts that on the back have illustrations of all three of those firehouses. The building here was built in 1958 and was originally the home of Engine 19 and Ladder 4 until 1960, when Ladder 4 went to Station 24, became Ladder 24 as it is today. In 1975, a basic life support ambulance, Ambulance 19, was established here, and then in 1987, that was upgraded with paramedics to an advanced life support ambulance that we have out here today. This year, however, we've been able to move Ladder 10, which is out in the street, from Station 1 to Station 19. With only a four-person crew here, they ran either the engine or the ambulance. Anytime they left the station for emergency calls, for training, or any other purpose, the building was empty of any emergency responders at all. First-in crews to an emergency had to respond here from other stations further away. Meanwhile, Station 1 had three crews in it, so it made perfect sense to move one of those crews over here. So when Engine or Medic 19 are out, Ladder 10 is here, staffed with four firefighters and qualified EMTs and the equipment to attack a fire or render first aid and evaluate a patient. The problem was there was no room here for either the vehicle or the crew. So it had to be expanded. We added this addition and remodeled the living crews. Now, so today we're having an open house. The firefighters here will be happy to show you through and out, but this is where firefighters work and live 24 hours a day, 7 days a week, every day of the year. We have fire prevention safety information. We have partnership with Regent Hospital here. Outside, we're gonna have, through the afternoon, two demonstrations of how they extricate people from crashed up cars. That's one of the aspects that bringing the ladder truck here brings to the neighborhood, is more immediate extrication. And they'll show you how they do that. We're gonna have a hose out here. The kids can squirt a fire hose with a firefighter. And we have an antique fire rig, so you can see, you can compare the two and see just how fire apparatus has advanced in the last 100 years. I know the police still use horses, but we stopped using them over 100 years ago. Anyway, so I hope you stay this afternoon, have a light refreshment, and enjoy the great work that they've done. Today, with us today is Mayor Chris Coleman. This expansion of Station 19 is just the latest example of the mayor's staunch support of the St. Paul Fire Department. Since he took office, we've added 30 people to the fire department, mostly with a federal FEMA grant that enabled us to bolster our EMS and fire service delivery to the community. We've also been able to start up and grow our celebrated EMS Academy, and they have a tabletop here. They'll be happy to take your blood pressures and record those for you. It's always good to know what that is. But our EMS Academy is where St. Paul youth, diverse St. Paul youth, get an opportunity to take EMT training, which is one of the requirements to become someday a St. Paul firefighter. Please join me in welcoming Mayor Chris Coleman.
Well, thank you, Steve. Thank you so much for being here. It's too bad it's a little bit of a wet day out there, but it doesn't dampen our spirits because this is a great addition to public safety in the city of St. Paul. As Steve mentioned, you know, we have had a great opportunity to continue to invest in firefighting resources, to invest in the department. Station 1, which was a combination of the old Station 1 and 10 off of Randolph, is with the new headquarters, was a very significant investment. This is represents, I think, a really good example of how we are building to better deploy our resources and making sure that we're serving the community all across the city of St. Paul better. Last year, earlier this year, we did a study, and one of the questions we asked is are the firefighter services, EMS services, that we provide in the city of St. Paul provided equally to everyone across the entire city, regardless of where you live, regardless of whether you are an immigrant or a person of color, regardless of your income levels? And the answer was a resounding yes, that across the city of St. Paul, no matter who you are, no matter where you live, you're receiving very, very high quality services. You're receiving those services very quickly, and St. Paul continues to be have among the best response times and the best survival rates of any city in the country. And we're very, very proud of that. But that only happens when you continue to invest and when you continue to build facilities out so that we can better serve the public. Station 19 is kind of has got a personal part of my heart because it was the very first fire station that I ever visited when I was a young kid. My neighbor, Chuck Corlath, was a firefighter for many, many years in the city of St. Paul. And he was stationed here, and so my dad took us down to see our neighbor Chuck, and it was really, I just always have that memory, even though I was probably only about 6 years old, maybe just a little bit older than some of the kids that are here today. But the fact of the matter is, as we have in the past, you know, upgrading from horses to actual motors in our engines, you know, that was a significant upgrade that I'm glad we made long before I became mayor. You know, in the 21st century, we need to continue to expand. We need to invest in the latest equipment, and we need to invest in our people. The EMS Academy that Steve referenced, I think, is a great example of that, making sure that our firefighting force reflects the diversity of our community, brings in those extra languages that are important when you go out on a call. But ultimately, one of the reasons why I do think that St. Paul is the most livable city in America is because of the work that are done by the men and women of the St. Paul Fire Department. On a daily basis, you make a difference in people's lives and you save lives. And we are very, very grateful for that. So congratulations on finally getting to this new facility, to the team that built it and designed it, but most importantly, to the men and women that will serve out of Station 19. This is a great new addition to our public safety complement in the city of St. Paul. Thank you so much.
Well, welcome everybody. So excited to be here today. So excited for this expansion. It helps make this ceremony possible since we had the rain outside. We can all fit in the new part of the building. This is really important to our neighborhood because it improves services, it improves response times, and it also improves the quality of living for the firefighters who live here. I had a tour before we did the station expansion and how small the living quarters were here for all the firefighters. But more than anything, as Highland grows, as McAllister Groveland grows, this is such an important aspect to our neighborhood so that we can have response times and enough people down here to respond to those. I think often about all the different things that comes out of here, and I think sometimes we as citizens take for granted that the firefighters and the EMT and the paramedics are there, but they're there when we need them, and that's what matters most. I think about the person who's having a medical emergency and the quick response time, and the first class service they're going to get from our firefighters, paramedics, and EMTs. I think about a fire in a building where the courageous people will run inside and save people and also stop a fire from spreading. And then I think even of last year when we had the terrible threats on the Jewish Community Center. And I stopped by here and I stopped by the Jewish Community Center and I thought of all those little three-year-olds and four-year-olds who are at daycare and thought, God, what would it be like to tell those kids we need to get out of here because there's been a terroristic threat? And I talked to the teachers and they said, oh, the paramedics and the firefighters, they brought them in and all the kids thought they were on a field trip. And it was that soft touch that's so important. I mean, so many different things, so much diversity in the skills that our firefighters and paramedics have to represent our community. So thank you. I want to thank my colleagues and all those on the city who helped make this investment possible. Obviously, I was a big supporter in the neighborhood. This is also the fire station that's closest to my house. And thank you to the firefighters who came out. I appreciate your service. And to all the neighbors who came out to support them, thank you. So have a great day, and I look forward to the expanded service.
As Steve said, thank you all for being here today, for the support of Mayor Coleman, Councilmember Tolbert, and for the men and women of the St. Paul Fire Department that really went through some interesting times while this construction project took place. We did, if everybody noticed, in the neighborhood, you had some trailers on the corner here for a little while because the men and women that reside in this fire station and deliver the services out of here needed to move out during the construction. The dust, the plumbing disruptions, et cetera, that you would expect from a construction project made themselves fully known and aware to all of the men and women that were here at the station. So they put up through some summertime heat out in the trailers that weren't necessarily the coolest, and they put out some days out there in the wintertime when they weren't necessarily the warmest. And the transition from the corner back into the station to get to the rigs to respond was an interesting, let's just say an interesting time nonetheless for them, but they all took the time and the determination to make sure that it worked. They made sure that they stayed in the neighborhood to assure that the fire and EMS services were delivered in a very timely fashion and didn't really disrupt anything that you folks, if you needed to call 911, would have received as services. So my hat's off to all of them because I did not live here during that time, but they did, and they stood up very strong and proud during that time. I won't belabor the events here today because I know we have a lot to cover, but I would just like to again thank the mayor, Councilmember Tolbert for their support, the design of this building. It was very, as you will see on the tours later through the day, has made a significant difference for how we house not only four people, but how we house eight. We had to do some expansions to make sure that we could fit all this equipment in the fire station. To go along with the people that stay here for 24 hours at a time. But thank you for your support. Chief Butler wishes he was here. I wish he was here because he would probably do a much better job of thanking you for your support and being here. But nonetheless, Have a great Saturday. Enjoy the events that are here for everybody, and thank you again for your time.
Thanks, Chief Simpson. Well-expressed appreciation. The architects for this great project were James O'Shea and Ben Metzdorf. James O'Shea is here. Raise your hand. Okay. They drew this up. This is their brainchild, and you know how to make this a much better firehouse. Carl Hinkle is vice president and senior project manager for the Tariff Construction Company. They built it. They were responsible. They were general contractors and responsible for completing the expansion and renovation of Station 19. Carl's going to talk just for a few minutes about what it's like to add on and build during an active firehouse and keep it in service. So, Carl, please join us.
Thank you for having me. Again, it was a honor to be able to work on this project, and I truly appreciate all the support from the city to the department, and especially to the occupants of the building, or maybe non-occupants of the building, depending on the time of the project. As in any construction project that involves a remodeling, there's always going to be issues that come up, some surprises, and this project was not an exception to that rule. But thanks to the help of the architects and collaborative design, we were able to address all of those issues and get through the project, I think, in a very good fashion. On a more personal note, I always found that being able to work with the fire department kind of gets closer to home. My father was on the fire department down in Mankato, and he retired after 20 years of service there. So it was a special item to be able to come here and participate in this project with you. Other than that, it was a good project, a great design, and from what I understand, you guys are able to facilitate your efforts here. So again, thank you very much.
So this one's a little smaller font than my last, so I'm gonna put my glasses on so I don't mess this one up. So we have two unit commendations. One is for the fire station crews on all three shifts that resided in the building and in the adjacent lot during the construction. But first, I wanna reflect on a mention that Councilmember Tolbert brought to light was the unfortunate terroristic threat that the JCC experienced next door down the street. The crew that was present that day is here working, so we wanted to make sure that we recognized their efforts, and I will read the letter that Chief Butler had written to get that recognition. Again, unit commendation award to the engine and paramedic company of 19 A shift. Captain Ken Adams, and if you guys could come up as I call your names, that would be great to stand up here. Captain Ken Adams, Captain Marie O'Keefe, FEO Kyle Van Pelt, Martha Fecht, firefighter, and then Todd Hansen, I believe I saw Todd here. If you want to join us, please, that'd be great. So as they make their way up, I'll read the letter as written by Chief Butler. The St. Paul Fire Department values and recognizes divisive leadership in times of crisis and the ability of on-scene leaders to maintain calm and order during chaotic incidents. In fact, at times, the only thing that keeps our society safe during sudden emergency situations is oftentimes the cool execution and good judgment and leadership of fire officers and public safety responders. Such were your actions that day on the morning of February 20th, 2017, when a bomb scare was called into the Jewish Community Center. The JCC staff, teachers, immediately implemented emergency response plans and evacuated the building. Nearly 200 staff, visitors, teachers, and students, including young children from the early childhood development class, sought shelter in a place that they knew to be a safe haven in their neighborhood. Fire Station 19, located just blocks away, within minutes, those fleeing from the JCC arrived here at Station 19, all unknown to the station members that were here that day. They didn't know they were going to experience that influx. You took immediate command and control of the situation and made everyone feel welcome, cared for, comforted, and safe. You established a continuous communications link to law enforcement personnel at the JCC. and worked with JCC staff to address the needs of the evacuated group and entertained the children with fire safety presentations, and even produced and provided kosher snacks for everyone in the building. Anxious parents looking on for information of their children arrived at the station to find their families safe and well cared for. Their relief was both immense and immediate. Conspicuous among the Station 19 crew members were the actions of Fire Captain Marie O'Keefe and EMS Captain Coordinator Ken Adams, both of who operated and distinguished their leadership capacity at the chief officer level throughout the incident in the absence of a superior officer. Your immediate response and actions, exemplary to leadership, demonstrated crisis management skills, true compassion for those displaced by this threatening event, and were supreme examples of what makes us invaluable to the community. Your actions are in keeping with the very high standards of the St. Paul Fire Department. Therefore, it is with great pride and appreciation that I present this Unit Commendation Award for your superior service on February 20th, 2017. Respectfully, Chief Tim Butler. Okay, and if I'm just going to have them stay up, I'm going to read one more real quick. Can you grab that? So the award that I'm going to present, and actually it's to all the engine companies and paramedic units that are staffed on all shifts, but since the A shift is the only ones that are present right now, this is another unit commendation to reflect what they went through as crew members to stay within the station. The St. Paul Fire Department values devotion and duty to duty and efforts that go above and beyond the call of duty in order to help residents serve their local neighborhoods. Such were your actions in 2016 and early 2017 when you put the needs of the residents in this neighborhood above your own comfort and safety. These actions went well beyond the level of effort typically expected from fire companies in the city of St. Paul and are worthy of significant appreciation and recognition. From May 16 through March 2017, Fire Station 19 in Highland Park underwent significant midlife renovation and expansion. The construction work included updated water, sewer, and electrical, crew dormitories, support spaces, and an apparatus bay to house Ladder 10. This was an extensive, it also included extensive landscaping, as you noticed outside. Plans to have the crews occupy the station during construction posed safety risks to personnel, and options to move the crew temporarily off-site quarters would have resulted in increased response times and decreased emergency services and availability. Rather than move out of the fire station, the dedicated fire and EMS crews at Station 19 elected to remain in the station and put themselves through the most arduous and austere conditions that any fire crew has experienced on the job. They endured dust, excessive noise, mud, and constant interruptions of their daily routines and essential services. Many of the crew members developed skin rashes, increased respiratory problems, and sleep and meal interruptions. When conditions inside the station became intolerable, crews moved on-site construction shacks, or the trailers that I explained, for dormitories and suffered the lack of air conditioning in the summer and heat in the winter. See, I wasn't joking when I told you that earlier. In reality, these conditions were totally unacceptable for our people. Yet these crews endured the conditions in order to maintain a fast response to the neighborhood in a close connection with the people they serve. Never before in this department have I witnessed such selfless sacrifice on a large scale and protracted timeline. Your dedication, however, created a safer neighborhood, a shorter construction project timeline, and a superior example of the devotion to the duty of the people we serve. Your commitment to the neighborhood cannot be overstated. And in keeping with the very highest principles of the Fire Department in St. Paul, it is my pleasure to award you all, as a department, this station unit commendation. Thank you for your service. Respectfully, Fire Chief Tim Butler.